Hello, I will talk about why you should not invite anyone to your home. If you do, be prepared to clean your table, clean all the balls, even clean the insides of your pocket. That is what you must do, because the friends, they don't understand anything about food, so they think the pockets are a trash can. I have seen many times chocolate paper inside the pocket, candy paper, even my trophy, even my trophy had a candy inside. What? My trophy was a trash can, and the pockets on my pool table were trash cans when people got invited here. So that is what I recommend. No friends, nobody should touch your table. And of course the balls were very, very messy, horrible, very oily, very dirty. And also I had cleaned the balls right before they came, and then after an hour they were messier than ever. The balls were very, very messy. I didn't even want to touch the balls. I had to use a glove to take up the balls because they were very, very messy. So I recommend you don't invite anyone over, because they will ruin the table. I have many permanent damages that has come from inviting people over. There's even a blood spot right there. Yes, a spot of blood on my cloth from other people playing on my table. That is bad. So if in the pool hall, I feel sorry for the owners who have to put up with all of this. With all the players, they mess up the tables, they have their drinks on the side of the table, they drop the beer all over the cloth, it becomes very messy. Of course it costs a lot of money to play in the pool hall, if that happens. So the pool hall owner has to pay a lot of money to replace the cloth after clumsy customers who drop a beer on the table, who even smoke, and the cloth starts on fire. I'm very lucky now that the smoking is forbidden indoors from the new law. That is very good. So I don't need to get any lung damage when playing in the pool hall anymore. But of course I recommend you have your own table at home, so you don't need to play on a messy table in the pool hall. My table is very clean, and I clean often. Not as often as I would need, but I want to play pool instead of spend my time cleaning. And if you get, you don't want friends to come over and mess up your table. Very, very easy to mess up a table if you don't know what you're doing. And of course, the people who come here have never tried pool in their life. They hit the ball with the other end. They go like this. And also some even go like that. They think it is some kind of tennis or something. Like they slam the balls like this with the side of the cue. I'm very lucky that my cue isn't damaged. This house cue is very, very durable, very good. I can understand why they are using the same cue in pool halls, because it is so durable. The Dufferin Q2, the best cue I have ever owned. Better than Predator, better than OB, better than Meucci, better than Falcon, better than McDermott. The house cue, Dufferin Q2, is the best cue of them all. By 10 times. 10 times better. And also the bonus is that it doesn't break. if you invite friends over. So if you must insist on inviting people over, yeah, you want to hide all your cues and keep this the house cue visible here. So they will use the house cue that is very durable. It is meant for using it in pool halls. Very durable. It doesn't have a joint, so it won't get damaged as easily as with jointed cues. I had a joint break on me with my McDermott cue, so I had to replace. I had to go to the pool Q-stick repairman, and my McDermott break cue had a wooden joint that I had to screw. When I wanted to make a jump shot, so I had to screw it up, unscrew it, and then the joint broke, so I couldn't screw it back together, so I had to get it replaced. And the cost to repair this cost the same as a new cue. That is a bad thing, bad idea to have a joint in your cue. If the joint breaks, buy a new one for the same price as to repair it. So my advice here is to not invite anyone over. Nobody should touch your cue. Yeah, people have someone wanted to borrow my cue, my Meucci cue in the pool hall, dropped it on the floor, damaged the shaft, so the shaft got a strange noise, so I couldn't use it anymore. I had to use my other shaft, but it was still working okay. But I found that, yeah, maybe it is all in my head, you know, but I found that I didn't play any good with the other shaft because someone dropped it on the floor. So I really don't know what has happened to the cue that I borrowed. And the same thing can happen with your table. So maybe you are wondering what has happened here on my table. Maybe they have sat on the side and that it is not level anymore. And then you start to doubt your skill, that maybe I shouldn't play it like this because it is not level anymore. And then you start playing a lot worse. So the ones you invite over, they make your game worse than before. So you want to avoid that. You want to keep your table fresh like it is, and not be worried about something being wrong in some places there, and you go around to check the table for errors. Is there something wrong here or here or here? And you go around wondering, yeah, maybe this is the reason why I played worse today. Maybe this is the reason that there's a small mark here. And you always keep wondering, what is wrong? Is there wrong with the equipment? But it is something wrong in your head, because I found that even on the worst conditions, I played really good. So it didn't matter what kind of equipment you had, I played still good. So after that day, I started doubting myself. I started doubting the table and just play pool. Don't worry about problems, any breakage of your equipment. So it doesn't really matter. It is all in your head. But to avoid that, you don't want to invite any friends over. Just when they ring the doorbell, just don't answer. Just let them wait until they go away, and then continue to play pool. Don't open the door and invite friends over. Just let them go away. Let them go away. That is my recommendation. So you don't want any friends. Forget about the friends. They ruin your game. You want to play the best pool, so don't invite anyone. If you have a family, maybe you should put a lock on your door into your pool room. You want to put a fence around. Put a heavy lock on your door that will keep away all your all your kids' friends. They want to be, they can't be in your room. Forget about it. They will leave candy, candy in the pockets, candy in your trophy, chocolate on the cloth. Oh, what a mess. I was very lucky that there wasn't any chocolate on my cloth. There was chocolate inside my pocket. I made a shot like this. I made it like this. And then I heard a sound, very strange sound. It was the sound of the ball landing in chocolate. That is what I heard. Plastic and chocolate sound when I made the ball, and my ball was very messy with chocolate. It was disgusting. So you don't want to invite anyone over to your pool room. You want to put a lock on that room. Remember that. You don't want anyone to mess up your table. This is your table. It is like sharing your table. It's like sharing your underwear. That is what it is. Sharing your pool table, same thing as sharing your underwear. So think about that. You don't want anyone to touch your table. Yeah. So that's the end of my video. Subscribe to my channel and check out my Patreon. The link is below. Click on it. I will make instructional pool videos there. So if you support me with $2 a month, you will get early access and see those videos many weeks before everyone else does. Isn't that great? So until next time, goodbye.